name is Carl Calderone, and I've been painting watercolor for about 35 years. Today we'll be working from a photo. You can take your own photos or find plenty of them on the internet. We started this project by going to a local farmer's market and gathering a few vegetables. Then we found a sunny spot where we could get good shadows and arrange the vegetables for a photo. I take lots of photos of the subject and sift through them later to pick out the one I'd like to paint. You'll need just a few basic supplies. Of course, you'll need a palette with a good selection of different colors. I use a Pigma Micron pen for the original drawing. It's waterproof. I use a couple of brushes, inexpensive, one quite large. I paint with a lot of water. Some wide blue painter's tape to tape down the edges. White for a little highlight, that's gouache paint. Spray bottle to wet your palette, and some clean water to dip the brush in. I always work on at least two paintings at the same time so I don't overwork one or the other of them. Letting watercolor dry between sections is important. I use several different kinds of paint. Core, Daniel Smith, and Winsor Newton. All right, let's get started. I almost always wet the area first, and then with a spray bottle, I wet all the paint in my palette. Then I fill the brush with some paint and begin dropping paint into the wet areas of the paper. I always start painting shadows first. This helps me to gauge the intensity of the other colors as they develop. Keep in mind that shadows are never gray. They are either cool with blues and purples, or warm with shades of reds or oranges. Here we're using purples. Now we've started to lay in some of the undercolors. Leaving bare white spots for highlights takes a little planning, but it's worth it. Notice that we're generally painting colors over top of the shadows we painted earlier. We gave them time to dry really well before starting to lay in the colors. Notice that dropping paint into an area that's already wet lets the paint spread really easily. It's important in watercolor to let the water do most of the work. Because the photo that we're working from was taken in bright sunlight, I'm using these warm undercolors, the yellows and the oranges, to show through the darker colors that'll go on top. Layering blue over yellow without mixing a wet paint makes green jalapenos. here we're adding a little bit more warm brown as a heavy shadow. Slowly, the characters start to emerge. Note the white highlights that we're leaving. Eventually, as the painting progresses, the shadows can be darkened for more contrast. Remember, shadows are never gray. They always have some measure of color, cool or warm. And a lot of that is affected by the objects that are around it. I like to work from photos that have strong shadows. The second painting helped me to keep from overworking the first. Thanks for watching.